Shall we start?
Yes.
So, hello everyone. I welcome you all for this session on Technology Drive, CAT. We are going to continue our sessions from where we have stopped yesterday, and we are going to do a quick recap by our own Amish sir. So, like, I just want to welcome CA Amish Thakkarji for continuing the session from where we have left yesterday. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, Yogesh. Ma'am, would you like to say anything before I start?
A very good evening to all of you. And let's learn the technology from the person who the CAT, you know, idea software day in, day out. And he's one of the best, I can say, to teach us this product. And friends, those are finding difficulty in installing, maybe you had earlier installed IDEA, that the reason is not been getting installed in demo. So tomorrow you can get in touch with Amit sir and he will say that, or you can have an alternative, you can have a laptop where you can install it. Wishing you a happy learning and enjoy yourself. Thank you everybody. Over to you, Amit.
Thank you, Kapoor ma'am. And I really, thank ma'am for having me here. She was really convincing me to take this session and I could not say no to her. So thank you, ma'am, for having me here. And let us quickly recap what we have done. So those participants who have done hands-on yesterday along with me, just 10 minutes, you should wait. It's a kind of a revision for you. And all those who have installed IDEA today, they can start practicing with me so that we are all at par and we can take the session forward from there. Okay. So I'm sharing my screen. Okay. Is my screen visible?
Yes, it is visible, sir.
Okay. So friends, this is for the ones who have not done it yesterday. So the first thing that you all need to do is please open your IDEA software and click on create option. This is the option that you should select. In the manage project, you can write the name Translogistic Private Limited Financial Year 21-22. Just give the name of the client and the period of audit. As usual, once you have completed, drop in a chat so that I can proceed. Good evening, Mr. Burney. How are you today? Everyone has done this. Shall I proceed? Okay. Invalid project name is because you have put in dot. Dot is not allowed. Any special character is not allowed. So that's the reason it is showing this. No dot. Okay. See, now I am clicking OK. It is working. So maybe you can type, say, any other name, say Bank of Baroda. Just try that. See if it's working out. Ramana Murthy. Invalid, sir. Okay. Very strange. Anyone else is facing the issue other than Ramana? So Ramana, are you going to create and typing here in the manage project? Hope you are not typing in the external project. It should be here in the managed project. Okay. Still you are facing a problem, correct? So what is the solution for you? Let's try that out. No, it's okay. Otherwise you will not be able to proceed ahead. You need to create a project. It is important, otherwise you can't operate. So what you should do, this is only for Ramana. At times your default folder is not acceptable because of admin rights. So what you should do is you should go to file, this option, then go to options, please come up to here, Mr. Ramana, go to file, and inside that there's an option, options, and then go to folders. Go to folders, and here in the managed project tab, this default path is not allowing you to save the project. Maybe this document folder in your machine is protected. So what you should do is click on these three dots and just select desktop and say OK. So this entire thing will change to desktop. Just try this out, please. Okay, now click on OK. When you click on OK, now go to create and see whether you are able to save the project now. Perfect. Excellent. So let us proceed. Friends, now that we have opened a new project, as I told you, the first thing that we have to learn is how to import. And yesterday we imported one file. That's what we are going to do it today as well. Okay. So yesterday we imported one simple Excel file which has got five columns and one sheet. Okay, the name of the file is savings account balance. So this is the file we are going to import now. So I'm closing the file. I'm going to IDEA. Please click on desktop, select Excel as an option. Browse, this is called browse, and after you browse you click on savings account balance file. This is the file you should select. Please come up to here and confirm. Click on next. If you remember yesterday's discussion, in the preview we need to observe the first row, and we all know that IDEA needs only records or the transactions. Headers should not come in the working area. Since headers are there in the working area, I have already done that, Durgesh. If you see here in the managed project, my project name is visible, Trans Logistic Private Limited FY21-22. Okay. Without selecting the project, you cannot import the file. All right. So to move this first row, which is a header, to the header position, we have to click on this option. First row is field names. So let's click on this option and click on OK. So this is what we have done yesterday. Clear, friends? Everyone, please keep replying in the chat. Let us have the same sort of interaction what we had yesterday. Okay. Great. So this is what we have done yesterday. Let us take over and resume from here on. Similarly, let us try to import one text file. Okay. So in our folder, we have a file Loan Master. This is how the original file looks like. Okay. What we will do is we will import this file so that there are proper rows and columns defined for us. So I close this file. I go to IDEA. I click on desktop. Now we are importing a text file. So by default, whenever you come to this dialog box, this option is selected. Click on Browse. Go to the Training File folder and select Loan Master. Click on Open. Please do up to here and we will proceed. Excellent. Now click on Next. You would observe that when we imported Excel, the dialog box was different. But now when we are importing a text file, it is very similar to converting text to column in Excel. Those who are using Excel, it is very similar to converting text to column. So here IDEA will ask you few questions by way of this dialog box, and IDEA will automatically select the correct answer. So here a lot of intelligence is developed in this tool. You, even if you don't know any of these options, since we are not technologically savvy, what delimited means, what fixed length means, what is EBCDIC length means, it doesn't matter. IDEA takes care of it automatically, or for that matter, any software in the CAT category. So now we will proceed. IDEA has automatically identified the type here, and you look at the preview. Right now, data is unstructured. You can't figure out the columns properly here. Okay. So when we click on Next, you would observe that IDEA has automatically identified the column breaks based on the tab and made our data proper. Again, in this preview, the rule is same. From the first row, it should have transactions. But what you see here, that the first row is a header. So there's an option here. First visible row is field names. So click on it. This you have to mandatorily select if there are headers. Then click on next. Now from here on, IDEA has automatically picked up the headers of each and every column. See? Now what we need to do is, account number is automatically considered by IDEA as numeric column, which is correct. Then account name is character. Scheme is again a character in nature. Now this is a limit sanction date, but the type is character. Here we have to change it to date. Why? Because this is a date. Now the moment you select the type as date, you have to give the mask. This is compulsory. How would IDEA know what is the date here? So you have to read couple of dates to identify the mask. Now if you see here the first date itself, which is 30th of October 2007. Now 30th cannot be the month. It is a date. So the format, yes, Durgesh is correct. We have to follow the format DD dash. Now there is a dash in between. So we have to put a dash MM dash, and the year is in four digits. So YYYY. DD MM YYYY. Now the moment you put a mask here, you will see the example that will show you whether your mask is picked up by IDEA correctly. So in IDEA, this is very important, all the dates follow YYYY MMDD. The dates identified by IDEA is in the reverse order. We write DD MM YY, IDEA understands YY MM DD. So this date is, you have to read reverse, 30th October 2007. So this date is picked up correctly using this mask. And every time you are importing a file, emphasize on the date column, because most of our calculations like aging analysis, interest calculations, overdue dates, all relates, or even your NPA analysis, date is very important. Okay. Then interest table code is character, and limit sanction is numeric with two decimals, so which is okay. So have you completed up to here so that I can proceed? Are you seeing your headers in the first column? Have you done the ticking on this? Very, very important. Okay. Perfect. Now click on next. Click on next. Click on next. And finally, we are on the not able to select text file. Any error message you are getting, Sachin? Any error message you are receiving? Okay, so now let's click finish. Yes, please specify a file name to import means. What you have done, Sachin, have a look. You have clicked on desktop. You have selected text and you are clicking on next. This is how you will get this message. What you have to do is you have to go to browse. You have to click here. You have to go to the folder and tell IDEA that I want to import loan master file. This step you have missed. Now when you select and click on next, you will be able to proceed ahead. So friends, what you see here is this. which was the original format, text format. This is how the data was given to you. Now imagine if you are not using tools like this, and these are like 50, 60 lakh records, you will struggle at the beginning only to handle such a large data and convert it in proper rows and columns. For analyzing the data, we need data in rows and columns. Now here, there are rows, but the columns are not proper. So this data is as good as no data if you do not use tools like this. Yes, Jignesh, you might have not defined the mask correctly. So no problem, I'll give you the solution. Now, what is the solution is? This is for Jignesh. If you are finding this as an error here, double click anywhere in the working area. Now, what are you seeing here, Jignesh? If you can type. Durgesh, that won't happen because whenever you extract data from an application follows a pattern of date. It can't change in the same file. Okay? If you are importing one file, the date will be common. You can't have multiple date formats in the same file because either you would extract data from Tally, SAP, in-house develop ERP, or any other CBS solution. So there the date format is always consistent. You didn't receive finish. My error is create fields. Okay. Okay. Jignesh is saying YYYYMMDD. Okay. So if you are. Okay. So I am repeating Jignesh. You can also do it along with me. Because since we have written the format correctly, despite that if there's an error, then I need to check your screen or we will repeat the same. Yeah, we will do it once again, no problem. Okay, so that whomsoever has not been able to import, they can do so. So this is for those who have not imported correctly. So what you should do is, please follow the steps. So first observe what I am doing, then I will tell you to do, that time you do. We will go step by step, okay? So please observe everybody. First I am clicking on desktop. Then text is automatically selected. I am clicking on browse. And I am going to the folder. Selecting loan master file. Please do up to here. We will go step by step slowly so you don't miss out on any step. Done, friends. Now click on next. Are you getting this particular screen? Okay, Mr. Ramana. Now click on next. Now here, please click on this option. Click on this option. After clicking, click on next. Have you come to this particular screen? Okay, now please click on sanction date, limit sanction date column. click here on the column header. Change the type to date. Change the type to date. Now here, please say DD dash MM dash YYYY. The moment you do this, this is what you have to type, what I have sent you in chat. The moment you type this, please observe here. It should come like this. That itself means that this mask is correct. Okay, friends. Then click on next. Nothing to be done on this particular screen. Click on next. Nothing to be done here. Click on next. Now all of you have come to the last screen where the option is finish. Please come up to here. Now once you are here, you are saying finish, just click finish and you will be able to import the file. If anyone is getting any error, let me know. Excellent, Ramana. Great, Sachin. Okay, Jignesh. So, all of you have imported two files. First file is savings account balance and the second file is loan master. Clear with everyone? So, we have learned how to import an Excel file, how to import a text file. Now, we have one file which is called payroll file, payroll March 2015 file. This is the file which is a MS Access file. This is a database file, one of the best file and the most compatible file with IDEA. Okay, so let us import payroll March 2015 file. Okay, so again we'll go to IDEA. Now please observe what I am doing. I am clicking on desktop and this time I am selecting the option Microsoft Access. Then I am going to browse and selecting payroll March 2015-pay.accdb file. This is the file I am selecting. Okay. Now click on open. Do up to here and confirm, please. Now click on next. Have you come to this dialog box? Now see, here there is no preview because IDEA files are database files and what we are importing is also a database. So there is no preview required and there is nothing that you have to do here except clicking OK. Now when you click on OK, a very big table with so many columns, automatically gets converted into IDEA file. So a piece of advice, whenever you are going for an audit, whenever you are extracting a data, to the extent possible, request your client to give you data in MS Access. This is the best format to work on CAD tools. Don't ask for Excel, don't ask for text file, print file. And databases are easy to handle. So everyone managed to import this third file also. Yes, friends. Okay. So today, are you all finding comfortable to use this tool? We are going very slow so that you can comfortably practice along with me. Okay. The objective is you should feel confident on the tool. We are not here to hurry up and run a fast train. We'll go slowly, we will understand things one by one logically, and then we do the analytics part. All right, so three different types of files: Excel file, then this one was text file, and this file we have imported was an MS Access file. Now there's one more type of file that we generally have is called as comma separated value file, CSV. CSV is kind of a text file, but which is more compatible with Excel. So it directly opens in Excel, but you have to still run a text to column option here. So this is as good as text file. Okay, so let us try to import this customer detail file. Customer detail file, okay, which is a CSV file. It is not an Excel file, okay. So let's go to IDEA. Let's go to desktop. Now which option I'll select? Anybody would like to help me here? Which option should I select for CSV file? There is no option called CSV here, correct? Yes, Ritesh. It is text option. It is not an Excel file. Okay, CSV files are other category files. So, a piece of advice. Whenever you are importing a file which is not listed here, then you have to go ahead with the text option. Like ASCII files, like CSV files. There is nothing like here for ASCII and CSV, so you have to select this. Okay. Now, with the text option on, click on Browse, go to CAD Training Files and select Customer Details. Select Customer Details. Click on Open. Select CustomerDetails.csv. See, this is a comma separated value file, not an Excel file, okay? Then I click on Next. Again, this dialog box, because it's a text file, IDEA has already selected this option. Data is still unorganized. Now I click on Next. See the magic? Data is now organized. On what basis? Basis comma. Why? Because it's a comma separated value. So whenever you find a comma, separate the value. Means insert a column break. As simple as that. Now, what is the next thing we have to remember? Looking at the preview, look at the first row. Now here, the first row is a transaction itself. That means this file has no headers. So if you click on this option, you are working on an incomplete file because the first record is disappeared. So I cannot select this option right now. Hope you are understanding. So every file has a different treatment depending upon the content. In the erstwhile file, I had a header, so I just clicked on it. Now in this text file, I don't have a header. So I click on Next. please come up to here and confirm, and hope you are understanding what we are discussing. Okay. Now see, I'll tell you real life problem. Whenever we go to client site and we extract the data, we mandatorily tell the client to provide us the files with a header. Imagine if you are extracting a very large file with about 100 columns, 120 columns without header. There are two problems that you will encounter. First problem is, without header, you won't be able to understand what the content represents. Like for example, now this 2004150, what is this? How do I know? Similarly, if the column contains some number, what that number is? Is it an amount? Is it a dimension? Is it some percent? We don't know. Or some sort of a code. So always ask for headers. Now the second problem that you will encounter is, you have to manually type the headers here. Now if you have a 100 column file, 200 column file without header, you will have tough time typing column headers for every column. Time consuming and waste of time. So what is the key thing that you need to remember? Whenever you are using CAD tools, whenever you are extracting data, you have to extract it with the headers. Please remember. So deliberately, I have given you one file without header so that you can practically experience the problem that we will face. Now see, here we all have to type the headers for each and every column. So now my first column is selected. I am giving the field name as ACCNO. And always give the field names in a short description. It should not be very long. Description is where you can elaborate. So this is a account number, something like that. Now this account number can be numeric also, it can be character also, it is up to us. Okay, but let us make it as a numeric, doesn't matter. So please complete the step. Give this headings to the column. Now we have more columns to give heading. So please click here on character 2. Now change the name to customer name. And in the description you can say account holder's name, something like that. And description is optional, it is not mandatory, so you can leave it blank also if you don't want. So we have given the name to the second column. Now the third one, here I am saying ADD. Description is address. Now next column, state, sorry, next column is city, and last column is state. So we have given five columns. Fortunately here there is no date column, otherwise we have to define the type, the mask and everything. And especially when you are doing bank audits, in one file you will have so many date columns. One is a value date, one is an entry date, one is a sanction date, one is an authorization date, one is an approval date, one is an expiry date. So many dates you get. Yeah, so each and every date has to be defined. So you understood the pain that we'll have. So this is something that you need to remember. Shall I proceed, friends? Yes, field names are generally in capital. Now click on next, click on next, click on next, and now say finish. Then nothing more, no more things to be done. Yes, herein there is a bonus that has been given to you. Okay, सो ऑल दोज हैव गॉट द सिक्स कॉलम, पांच पे एक फ्री मिला आपको. एनीवेज जस्ट अ लाइटर नोट, जस्ट इग्नोर दैट, यू कैन डिलीट दैट कॉलम. ओके, यस्टरडे वी लर्न दैट वंस यू इम्पोर्ट द डेटा यू कैन नॉट डिलीट द डेटा, यू कैन नॉट डिलीट द रो, यू कैन ओनली डिलीट द कॉलम. सो एनी लकी पर्सन लाइक हिरेन, एनी वन एल्स हु हैव गॉट द सिक्स कॉलम? या दुर्गेश, इवन आई हैव गॉट फाइव कॉलम्स, वी आर नॉट दैट लकी. हिरेन इज लकी. ओके, या एवरी वन आइडियली शुड हैव गॉट फाइव कॉलम्स. The sixth one is blank, so we can remove it later also, no problem. Oh, even Shirish is lucky. Okay. So, since the start of the session, we have imported four different types of files and have converted all of them into IDEA file. See? They are all similar looking. So unless you know how to convert, you can't do analytics, isn't it? Now just a quick check. Anyone, any question? All okay so far? Okay. Would you like to import one file on your own? Just for your comfort, you like to import yourself? Okay. So now, yes. So the file that you should import is this file, savings account balance underscore revised. This is the file you all should import. Just try it out, please. The file that is highlighted on my screen is the file you have to import. No, my friend, this is a Excel file. Look at the type here. This is a Excel file. If it is a CSV, it will be written like this. Microsoft Excel, comma, separated value file. But this is a Excel file itself. Excellent, Durgesh. Great, everyone. So now, happy days. We have all crossed the first milestone of knowing how to import. So let me import it as well. So, desktop, Excel, browse, CAT training files, savings account balance revised, open, next. First row is again a column name. So, first row is a field name, and I say OK. Simple, isn't it? Now, tell me friends, today, no matter what sort of audit you do, we all have to mandatorily zooming shortcut is you have to just open your fingers on the mouse pad like this. You have to keep two fingers on your mouse pad and do it like this. This is how you can zoom. Alternatively, you can go to view and there's an option called zoom. This is another way you can zoom. But if you follow here, then you have to every time, you know, select this option. But I prefer, I put my two fingers on the mouse pad and I open those fingers. It's like sliding on the mouse pad. It works in my machine very seamlessly. Sir, first few steps are reduced if we use drag and drop method. Correct, Shirish. I appreciate that. this is a shortcut of dragging and drop. We can kind of avoid few steps. But as I said, you know, we are having a batch of 70 people. Not everyone is comfortable with that. And there's a merit in doing this desktop. So when we'll go to the macro, okay, if you do a drag and drop, that step is not captured in macro. Okay, so many people who have the habit of drag and drop, they fail to understand why macro is not working. So it's better to learn systematically, no? So since many of you are learning it for the first time, we are going in the proper way. Once you become pro, you can explore the way you want. All right, now what was the query? I have answered all the queries. Now I was discussing one important point. See friends, no matter what type of audit we do, all of you understand the importance of audit documentation, isn't it? Even our auditing standards of our institute mandates us to maintain meticulous audit trail and audit documentation. In case of peer review, have you ever undergone peer review, or have you ever done peer review audit of any other CA? Have you ever done it? Anyone on the group? It is a nightmare, you know, when somebody comes to us, asks for the documentation, or when I go and do a peer audit of some another CA. The problem is that majority of the chartered accountants, they do not have enough documentation in place. Some papers are lying somewhere else, some files are missing, some files are not available, and everything what is in paper is available, but everything that they have done in computer, they can't explain. And many a times when we go for peer review, the staff who have done the audit have left the firm and have joined somewhere. So the CA poor fellow says, sir, abhi kya kare? I don't know how we did audit, but we followed everything. But if I have to sign that he has done everything right, I need proofs, no? Now I am showing you something very, very useful. Whenever we are using tools like this, any tool under the category of CAT, by default, these tools maintain audit activities trail. They maintain audit documentation for you. Now, since the start of the session, we have done four steps, four activities. Now, if you want to know what all you have done, then you have to click here on project overview. This is very, very unique to this tool. And this is a blessings for us. You remember our discussion yesterday? CATs are specialists. They exactly know what auditors want. Okay, so click on project overview. Now see, totally five files we have imported since the beginning of the session. First one was from the Excel. This is the name of the file, name of the sheet, and .imd is the extension of idea file. Second is a text file, loan master. Third is a payroll file from the Access. Fourth is a text file, customer details. And fifth is again an Excel file. Now tell me, isn't it beautiful? Now this might be looking clumsy. This doesn't look so presentable. So when you click on the table option, see now, this is absolutely proper with the name of the user, with the date and timestamp. Isn't it? Now, when we'll complete our session on fifth day, you will see plenty of activities will be automatically added here. And one more thing that we auditors face, we conduct audit today. Now, inquiry comes after 3 years, 5 years, whenever there's a scrutiny, whenever there's a case going on in the court of law, the matter will be called. Now, we humans, we remember things for a very short period of time. Today, if we have concluded audit, maybe for 6 months you will understand, remember everything. But what if the inquiry comes after 2 years? If the scrutiny happens and your audit report is called for testimony, or you are being called, what have you done? How will you explain everything? When you are using Excel, is there any trail being maintained in Excel? Don't get me wrong, I am not criticizing Excel, okay? Excel is a fantastic tool and we can't ignore it. But I am saying what we need in terms of audit log, audit documentation, that facility is missing. Now here, I don't have to remember. Even after the query comes 4 years, 5 years hence, you can simply come to the log, and when you click here, no, a complete detail is visible. You have imported file from which folder, what was the original, you know, original source of the file, which sheet within the file, how many records you have imported. You remember you selected first record as a field name, so it is selected as true. To that extent of minute detail, for everything that we are doing is getting saved. Now I tell you, we were appointed to do an investigation of Reliance Power IPO scam. Anybody who has invested in Reliance Power IPO in 2009? Now the SEBI has called us after we submitted our report in 2009, and SEBI has called us somewhere in 2013 seeking some clarity on our audit report. Now remember, by that time the team who has done the audit has left my firm and have joined somewhere. I was the only one in my firm who knew because I had signed that report. Now imagine, no team with me, and I am the only one to reply to SEBI's queries. So softwares like this helps us to rebuild the past, recollect what we have done and submit it. Okay, so this is very, very important. So now simply click here. From where does it pick up the username? So what happens is it picks up the username from your Windows operating system. Okay, so when you boot your laptop, it asks for your username and password. So it picks up from there. So this tool works very closely with your Windows operating system. Your date settings, your time settings, your geographical settings, yeah, all of that, even your number pattern, comma, dots, everything is picked up from operating system setting. So if you have an IDEA installed in your laptop, and if this laptop is used by 10 users, whomsoever user will log in, his name will appear here. Okay. Now what I have shown you is a project level overall log. What IDEA provides is a file level log under history section. Now in the project overview, the log was for all the files put together, but when you come to a particular file, let us say that I am in the savings account balance file, and when I click on the history, it will show me individual. How to come back? Just click here on the right hand side top corner. You have to just close the window, then you will come back to IDEA. Okay, when you come back to IDEA, select the first file, savings account balance, click on the history. When you click on the history, you will come to this particular screen. Now this is a file specific history, which means when I click here, it will show me full details. Look at the depth of the log that has been maintained here. What it shows you? It shows you that you have imported this file on this date at this time by this user from this folder. This was an Excel file. This particular sheet you have imported, it has got 1000 records, database truncated because it is a demo version. You have selected the option first record as a field name, and this is the IDEA script. Scripting is used for performing the repetitive task. I will come to this on the fourth day. This is little advanced. Right now we will not get confused with this, okay? Now similarly, I went to the loan master file and I clicked on the history. So this is the history of loan master file. See, it has got Pi 63 records. This was a record definition name. Yeah, and this is an idea script. Where is the history? Ramana, you can see here on the right hand side. See my cursor. Now from the history, if you want to come back, you have to just select the data option. So this is how you can toggle between any screen and the data. Wherever you are on this idea, if you want to come back to your file, you have to simply click on the data option. Is that okay? This is basically how we navigate in idea. Any questions? Logic for having file names at two places. I haven't understood your query, Durgesh. Left side and upper. Okay. So there is a logic to it. If you see here, the names here are of those files which are open in the working area. At any given point in time, you can see one file on your screen, but in the back end, you can open as many files as you want. Like for example, the payroll file is open, customer detail is open, savings account balance is open. So I can toggle it from here. But this is your file management system. It is not connected to this. This is just a working area. And in the working area, there are these many files open. So this section is completely different. And this is your folder management, meaning it will tell you how many files you have in this folder called Translogistic. Now suppose I am working on large files. Yeah, I am working on say file with 20 lakh, 30 lakh records. So your working area is going to consume a lot of memory. So it is advisable not to open so many files. You can close these files if you don't need it. So how to close the file? Simply close by clicking here. See, these files are closed. In real life, we end up opening 30-40 files. Now, if you close individually, you have to select them one by one. So right click here and say close all. When you say close all the files are closed. Now if you want to open it again, you have to just simply double click, so it will open again. Yes, Girish. Yes, Gitesh. I don't know, Shirish. Maybe a software vendor would tell us. I have no idea. Okay. Maybe it's your operating, which operating system you are using, Shirish? Is it Windows 11? Okay, then I don't know. Because Windows 11, because of the security, it changes the extension of many files. No, Ramana, once you have imported these files, it stays forever till you delete. So now see, I closed all these files. Everything is closed. Now I don't have to re-import. It is already here. I have to just select and double click. So it will open once again. See? So closing the file will not delete the file. It will retain the file. Now we have come a halfway mark, so it's time for us to take a small 5-minute break. Just get up from your chair, let the blood circulate, see outside, take some fresh air, and come back. We will see some more functions here. Is that all right? How can you open all together? Why would you want to open all together, Mr. Balaji? Yeah, ideally we should open one at a time. So like I opened this, then I opened this, then I opened this. But if you want to close all of them, yes, right click and say close all. So just a quick 2-3 minutes break and come back. How to zoom? So view. Okay, let me open a file. You can say view, zoom, and select whatever percentage you want. 200%. You can have a custom zoom like 80, 250%, something like that. So this is how you can zoom. Go to view and zoom. Okay. Are you all back? All right. Now, let us – Durgesh, I just gave a 2-3 minutes small break in case if somebody wants to take a bio break, or it's always good after 45 minutes, 1 hour, a small 5 minutes break is very effective. Because continuously we are staring at the screen and all, no? So I just thought of giving a small break. You were busy, engrossed in idea, so you might not have heard it, Durgesh. Are you all back? Since I am only interacting with Durgesh. Okay. So now, let us do one function which has its own importance, and I'll tell you why do we do that. Now see, what we did was we have converted data from one format to another format, correct? Like Excel to IDEA, text to IDEA, Access to IDEA. It is always good to do a hygiene level check. We should always perform a check whether there is any loss of data due to conversion. Now these are time-tested softwares, so beyond a point, once we get the comfort on the tool, we don't do it. But in future, if you are going to use a tool which is not that popular or vendor is new in the market, then you should look for hygiene level checks. As an auditor, this is the practice that you should inculcate in your firm. Now, what happens is that, let's say I have imported this savings account balance file, correct? Where is the savings account balance file? Here. Yeah, this is the file I imported. Now, this file contains the data of savings account customer. So there are certain fields which are mandatory in nature, which has to be in the file. Like none of the row should have blank account numbers, correct? None of the row should have blank branch codes, because every account, some or the other way, is associated with the branch. So if these two columns are mandatory columns, then we have to check that while converting, are there any issues in these columns? So please note, on your right-hand side, there's an option called Field Statistics. So when I click on Field Statistics, it gives me a message like this, and I have to say yes. Please try up to here. Please come to this report, then I will explain further. All of you have come to this report. Now, we are looking at all the columns which are numeric in nature. Like account number is numeric, branch code is numeric, so as other two columns. Now, what is it that we have to check is this number of zero items. See this. Account number is a mandatory column, and number of zero items means are there any records? How many records we have in this file? 999. This is also visible here. You see where I'm highlighting my cursor? In your status bar, it says this file has 999 records. Here also it shows the same. And it also tells you that out of 999 records, there is no record which is having account number as blank. And this is exactly what we need. If there is anything other than zero, it will show you that record, and you can go and check why account number is missing in that record. And then you can trace back to your original file whether account number is missing in the original file also. If it is missing in the original file, that file is invalid. You have to ask for the new file from your client. Sometimes it might happen that in the original file the account number is there, but while converting, IDEA has not picked up that account number and therefore it has removed that number. Because at the end of the day, these are softwares, no? Anything can happen. So it doesn't take much time, but this is a good practice that I follow in my firm. Similarly, my friend, branch codes. Branch code is a mandatory column, so there also it should not be any value. Now you see, in the balance today, I have got 13 entries. So out of 999 accounts, there are 13 accounts whose balance today, which is balance as on 31st March, is zero. Now when I click on this 13 records, it will open up those records for me. And you observe, in this column, all 13 accounts have no balance. But this is perfectly okay with me because balance can be zero, isn't it? So I have no issues here. But these two columns are mandatory, so it should not have anything other than zero. Similarly, date is also a mandatory column, but in this file we don't have any date. Okay, Priyanka, I'll repeat the steps. What I did was, I opened this file, savings account balance, I double clicked on it, then I went to field statistics, which is here on your right hand side, and this report is generated. That's it. Just try it out, please. Hope you have understood this. Now, similarly, let us go to Loan Master. Now, in the Loan Master, the account number column should not be blank. The scheme code should not be blank. Limit sanction date should not be blank. Yeah, so there are some columns, and even your loan sanction limit. Limit cannot be zero, no? So there are columns where zero value is a concern for us. So again, I'll do what? I'll go to field statistics and I say yes. Now if you see here, there are two numeric columns. How to select loan master? Just double click on it. Just come here and double click. It'll open. Then come to the right side and select field statistics. Any file, Ramana, if you want to open from your left hand side, just double click, it will open. And if you see, Ramana, now I have two files here in the working area. So I can toggle. This is my savings account file, this is my loan master file. See how simple it is. And that's the reason why it is appearing in the top. All the files which are open will reflect here, and you can just with the single click toggle between them. Okay. Now see here, in the account number, there are six items which are zero. Now let's open this. See, there are six accounts where the value is zero, even the date is zero, and the sanction limit is zero. So now, what is your job as an auditor? Check whether in this original file also we have something like this as a zero. Now if you see, your original file was this loan master. Now if this file is given to you in a text format, and if it has got 20-30 lakh records which you can't even open in this file, it is practically next to impossible to find a zero here, correct? So the piece of advice is, never ever, to the extent possible, extract data in text format. Many a times client will say that extracting in text format speeds up the process. It maintains the size of the file to minimum. But we don't bother with that. We have to say we have enough time. Let it take 2 more hours, but I want it in Excel or I want it in Excel, at least you can trace those records, no? So many times for their convenience, they'll give you this dump. Never accept this. Okay, so now I have got this six records which are blank, but I can go ahead with that because rest everything is also blank. So these may be some redundant records or excessive records. So I am still okay with that. Hope you have understood. Similarly, friends, when I click on date, I will discuss this entire report little later. This is a very, very important piece of report which this tool generates. But right now we are discussing one important point with regard to integrity of the data after conversion. So everything that we discuss has a meaning to it. Similarly, friends, if you look at date, number of zero items means there are six records, the same six records where the date is blank. Okay. So this much you have to do every time you import the file. And this comes from the field statistics. And now from this report, to go back to your data, you have to simply click which option? Data. Are you clear, friends? Is there always three types of fields? Durgesh, right now up to version 11, in the field statistics, there are only three types of fields. In version 12, they have added character type also. So you can do a similar sort of analysis on the character field. But what we have seen, the usefulness of this feature is always on these three types, numeric, date and time. Okay. Because mostly not getting any numeric field statistics. Okay, Sachin, on which file you are working out? On which file you are doing this? Loan Master. So, could you confirm whether your first row is a header or first row is a transaction? This account number is reflecting in the first row itself or it is reflecting in the header? If you have not selected first row as a field name, your first row is like me or first row is a header in the Loan Master? Same as of you. So if it is same as of me, then bring your cursor on the header and see what it shows. Does it shows like numeric? Does this sanction limit shows numeric? Just bring your cursor and it will pop up. It is showing as a character. This is very strange. Okay, so what you should do is you should double click here and change this. Change account number from character to numeric. Yeah, then go to sanction limit, change character to numeric. Ideally, it should not show character. Yeah, I think this is the problem you are only having, not others. Am I correct? How to come to this screen? Just double click. This is a working area. Just double click any. Then once you are here, Sachin, you can just click here and change it to numeric. Okay. Now after you change it, then when you close and come out of this window, how to close and come out? You have to just say okay. Just say okay here. You will receive a message. Click on yes and come out. Now Sachin, click on field statistics and you will see numeric values here. Yeah, just confirm please. Once you have done, great. Now, let us look at one option, which is duplicate. Okay. Now, account number is a very unique column. All of you agree? And this is a list of all unique account numbers and their details, correct? So I want to know, are there any account numbers which are duplicates? So just have a look how simple it is. You don't have to write any formula, you don't have to remember the syntax, nothing. Just simply what you have to do is, first you observe and then I'll give you time to do it. Okay. So now, in the savings account balance file, you go to analysis. Analysis is here. And there's an option called duplicate key. So when I click on duplicate key, I get three further options: detection, exclusion, and fuzzy. So since I want to find out duplicate key, I select detection. So I click here. Please come up to here and I will wait for you. Here you get two sub options: output duplicate records, output records without duplicate. Both are different options. So since I am looking at output duplicate records, I will select this option, the first one. Now I have to tell IDEA on which column you should run a duplicate check. So for that you have to click on key. So when you click on key, a new dialog box will appear. By default, first column is automatically selected, and this is the column we want to run a duplicate on. So here you have to just simply click on OK. Please select OK. And now give the name of the file as duplicate savings account. Duplicate savings account. Now your formula is already written, and the good news is that after you click on OK, the result will be saved automatically in the new file. You are not changing the originality of this file. In Excel, whenever you find duplicate, it shows you the records there and there itself. Here it exports it into the next file, new file. Okay, shall I click on OK? Have you configured everything correctly? This is what you have to do. Click on key. This is the one which gets automatically selected. Click on OK. Give the name of the file and click on OK. Now see, a new file is created automatically for you. Is this the output you are all getting? So, one more thing that you will observe on your left hand side is here. See, This is your main file on which you have executed the command. Your main file is intact. And just below the main file, there's a child file. This is called as a child file. If you see, there's a plus sign here now. So anything when you click on the plus, it gets extended and it shows the child file. So when you click on the child file, the result is automatically saved here. There is no control S, there is no need to, you know, separately save. Everything is real time. Yes, Gitesh, any IDEA file you can export back into Excel. Let me show you that right away since you have asked, otherwise I'll forget. But first of all, have you all understood this duplicate check? Do you think it is easy to do? Simple to remember? Now, before I do what Gitesh has said, let me add one more thing here. Nowadays, the thing is that one column duplicate check is actually not that you should follow. There is a concept called same theory. It actually originated in the forensics practice, but now because of the tools like this, you can implement it in any other audit. Now tell me frankly, looking at this report, do you really think that these accounts are duplicate? What are your views? So now I am moving from learning the tool to applying the logics, which is where our chartered accountancy knowledge will help. Yes. Do you all agree with Gitesh? Do you all agree with Gitesh? Do you have a differing opinion? Yes. Only last two duplicates. Very correct, Anil. Anybody can guess that of the five, why Anil is saying that last two are duplicates and rest of them are not? Yes, probably what Govind is said is correct. Along with the account number, branch code is same here. But one can argue that their status is different, their balance is different, then how come they are duplicates, isn't it? If I am the person on the other side of the table, I say I disagree. Yeah, other than account number and branch code, everything else is different. Not possible to have account number for different branch. Sorry, Sachin, I haven't understood your query or your statement. Not possible to have account number for different branch. Even though the account is dormant, the same account number cannot be allotted to any other customer. In that case, my friend Govind, even this is the case, no? Three different accounts, three instances of the same account opened in three different branches having three different balances. So obviously, if the additional information about the customer is available, we could verify whether the customers are same or not. Hope you are understanding. Account number must be different for different branches. Okay, you are right, Sachin. Account number across the bank is unique. It should not happen that account number 1001 is given to customer in branch number 30 and 1001 is also given to customer in branch number 35. 1001 is given. No. Even if branch codes are different, account number is unique in the entire bank. That's the philosophy we follow. So, all of you, what you have said in one or the other way is correct. But today, when I run a duplicate key detection only on the single key, which is account number, and I get this 5 instances. Imagine if I put this in my audit report and go to the bank and say, hey, look, in this 5 instances, there are 2 accounts. One is appearing twice and one is appearing 3 times. These are duplicates. You will be thrown out of the cabin. So today, running a duplicate check on a single column is outdated. And what is generally the repercussion of duplicate? It is generally an error. If a record is duplicate, means all the information that it is going to contain in the record is going to be same. Then only you will say it is duplicate, no? Like, if the account number is 123, name of the customer is Amish Thakkar, branch code is 32, balance is 1 lakh, and the same record with the same information is reflecting again, where everything is same, then only it is duplicate, no? Here, it is not duplicate. So, same theory says that you apply duplicate check on all the unique values. And here, account number is unique, branch code is going to be unique, balance is going to be unique. So, you apply on all of that. And if you get any record, that is a duplicate record. This is not a duplicate record. So, what IDEA has done simply, and doing this multiple 2-dimension, 3-dimension, 5-dimension check is very, very, yes, Sujesh. Now he is revealing my secret. Main janbujh ke usko suspense rakha tha, but he has revealed it. So I'll come to that in a while, but let me show you how convenient it is to do a multi-columnar duplicate check in one go. You can perform n dimension, meaning if your file has 50 columns and of the 50 columns there are 20 columns which are very unique, you can perform 20 column duplicate check in one go. That is the power of this tool, or for that matter any tool. So how do I do? So I say duplicate key detection. Please hear me out. Again, I am clicking on key. And here, instead of one key, I am saying, show me those records where account number is same, where status is same, where branch code is same, and where balance today is same. See what I did? Just one click, and I selected one dimension. It is that simple. So if I've got 20 columns, I have to just keep selecting. That is it. So what is the difference between the first command and this command? That was a simple, outdated, one-dimensional check, which is not at all going to add any value. Here, you have a specific four-dimensional check. Now, it all depends upon the management of the auditee. Suppose your auditee says that we consider accounts as duplicate when the account number and the branch code is same, which is what Anil said, which I also agree to a certain extent. Okay, I think Anil was the name. Yeah, Anil. If we go by that logic, then you have to delete this last 2 keys and select branch code. Then this is also same. Same means the duplicate check run or executed on more than one column. So here, if the bank's logic is, if you find any account number and branch code same, even if everything else is different, we will consider it as duplicate and we will investigate why. So if I apply with this and I say okay, and I say okay, then see, I get 2 records which Anil was mentioning. So here account number is same and branch code is same. But in the first instance, what Sujesh has said is correct. What Sujesh has said? It is an intentional error. This is a fraud. Now imagine these 2 customers. Yeah. It is in the same branch. Suppose we are going as an auditor of this branch. We have a branch audit happening. and this customer is about to default as an NPA, and the branch manager doesn't want an auditor to look at this account. So what the auditor simply does, changes the status to inactive. Okay. Hope you are understanding. The modus operandi could be anything. I'm just citing one of the reason for doing this manipulation. Now, if you go with the one dimensional, and you will say, no, these accounts are duplicate. No, these are not duplicates. There's a manual intervention, and once this account status has been changed manually. Okay. Now, in the first scenario here, this account has been made inactive, although the balance is very small. Imagine this is a very significant balance account, and the status has been made inactive in the branch 49 deliberately. Why? Because branch 49 has a higher amount of NPA, and all inactive accounts auditors won't check for NPA, because they would assume that inactive accounts cannot be an NPA. So these are simple ways by which a management can fool auditors. Okay. Hope you have understood what I'm trying to drive at. So don't consider them as duplicate. Think about that there can be an error or a fraud. Now, there is a log being maintained here. So see how the log has been created. So I click on history and see there is one log created here. Duplicate key detection. Now, when I click on the plus, it will exactly tell you the step-by-step activity that you did, on which file name the final outcome of this duplicate detection is saved. Duplicate savings account.imdc. This is the file in which the outcome of the command is saved. What is the command? How many records the command has found? 5. Okay. On which file the command was executed? Savings account balance database IMD, which is your parent file, this. Okay. How many records the parent file had? 999. On which field I executed duplicate check? Account number. What is the duplicate option I selected? Output duplicate item. Creating a virtual database? No, I have created a physical database, which is this file. Now imagine, this is a complete detailed audit log. What else we need? Step by step, minute of the details, systematically available. Print it for each and every file. Take it to your mind and say, this is what we did. Yeah, look at this duplicate. History. See here, rest everything you have understood, but look at this. Here I have used two keys. Yeah. Another beauty I'll tell you. Suppose I run a duplicate key detection, and my client says that if all the columns are same, then only we consider it as a duplicate, which means I've got 5 columns and I have to run duplicate check on all 5. It's a 5 dimensional. So I click on key. Correct? How simple it is. I selected all the 5 dimensions. I clicked on OK. I clicked on OK. See, there is no record. Everything is blank in this file. Everything blank means that there is no record which is exactly duplicate. But what I want to show you is this. Even if there is no record found, IDEA is going to create a new file for you with a red color sign. Now you must be wondering that if there is no output, why a new file is created with a blank record? Because tomorrow you can prove to your client that, hey, look, we did this command. We ran this duplicate check on all these 5 columns, and we haven't found any record. So don't blame us that we have not done our job. We have done our job, and this is where it is. we did the same on this date, this time by this user, you can check. So to that level of data you can keep to prove your work. Like when I am appointed to do a forensic audit, many times we are told to run a Banford check, Banford analysis on the data. We are supposed to run a relative size factor theory. Now they all pay us for doing all this activities on the data. But when we go back, they want an assurance that we have done it and we have done it right. So we take them through the log, and at times our logics could be wrong. So they correct our logic. So when we are explaining them that this is what we did, these are the columns that we have taken, and this is how we have got this outcome, they say, sorry, there's something wrong in your understanding. You should not have taken this column, you should take this column. Fine, then we do it again. But the point is that you have something to discuss with the client. If you have used tools like Access, Excel, or Oracle, or RDBMS, or SQL, there's no log to prove what you have done. Are you all aligned with me? Are you all appreciating what we are discussing? Can we edit our steps instead of creating new files every time? See, the beauty, Durgesh, lies in all these new files. Suppose you don't need this duplicate anymore, where you think your understanding was flawed, and this duplicate, the first one, this is an incorrect output, and this you don't need, then you can delete this file. There is a way to delete this file. But the very objective of this particular software is everything that you do, it should create a new file. Because every new file will have a different finding. So you can simply go to your client and say, hey, look, when I did a one dimension check, these are the records. When I do a two dimension check, these are the records. When I did a five dimension check, there are no records. So if you have so many files, you can easily showcase to your client the kind of work that you have done. Now, in this situation, you know that this one dimension is absolutely not acceptable. Fine. Then you close this file, close the file which you want to delete, right click on that file and say delete. And yes, so this file is permanently deleted. And this deletion is also recorded in the project overview. Have a look. See? In my project overview, the file that I just deleted, there's a record created here, see? So even deleted files, the record will be available here. Who deleted? Why in red color? Because it is a delete file. It doesn't exist anymore in the folder. Only the name is there. जब कोई लोग मर जाते हैं तो उसका नाम रह जाता है ना, हम उसको हार चढ़ाते हैं. So the red color means this file is not there. Okay. No, we cannot recover. It is gone forever. It is deleted permanently. Okay. All right. So far, so good, friends. Now, I'll simply show you some more facts about what we can do with these files. Now, I have this file which has got the details of the customer. This is a customer detail file which we have imported. You remember we have typed the headers also. Yeah. And I have this file which is a savings account balance file. Now, some information is here. What is the information? For account number 63604592. Details about the account is here, and for the same account number, the details about the customer, his address, city and state is in another file. Now I want to combine these two files. Hope you understand. What is it that I want to do? I want to combine these two files, join these two files. So look at this. It is so easy here. So now I am doing it. I will give you time to do it. So first observe. Okay. So I'm closing all the files so there is no confusion. I'm opening this savings account file once again. This is my savings account file. Okay, now where am I going? I am going to analysis. I am clicking on join. See, there's an option called join. Okay, so all of you, please close all the files and again open savings account balance file. Just do up to here. Again, this is not mandatory to close the file, but I am showing you the best practice also. Have you done it, friends? Have you opened this file? Okay. Now, please click on join. Please click on join. When you click on join, a new dialog box will appear. Again, as I said, this software doesn't need to write any formula. You have to simply fill in the gaps. Whatever software is asking you, you provide. Now, join means you are joining two files. So there's going to be a primary file, there's going to be a secondary file, correct? Logically. Now, this is your primary file. Which is your primary file? Which is open in the background. By default, it is picked up by IDEA. How many records it has? 999, correct? Now, IDEA is asking which is the file you want to join, which is the secondary database. So you click on select. Which file you will select? Anybody? Which is our secondary file? This is customer details. Ramanamurthy, the join option is, let me close this. Join option is here under analysis. You click on analysis, then you click on join. Have you got it, Mr. Ramana? So click on the secondary file and you select which option or which file? Customer details. Select this and say OK. So I've got two files to join. OK. Now, whenever you join two files, it is nothing but what? It is nothing but you are combining the file, which means in both the files, there has to be one common column. This is something that you do in VLOOKUP in Excel. Whenever you do a VLOOKUP in Excel, you have a common column in both the sheets or both the files. The logic is same here for joining. So now I have to tell IDEA that from both the files, you match the records. So click on the match. You match the records on the basis of account number. See, you just select account number here. Please complete up to here. So what we have done, we have clicked on join. We have selected customer details. Then we have clicked on the match option. And I have selected account numbers. Have you completed up to here? See what happens, Durgesh. First column is automatically selected. And in our case, account number is a first column. Otherwise, you have to click on the drop down and select if the column is other than the first. So this is the convenience it has offered. Okay. Now I click on OK. Now I am saying that look at this account in the secondary file and give me customer details, correct? So there is an option called all records in the primary file. So it will look at all the records in the primary file, and where it will look in the customer details, and it will join the file. So select this option. Let the file name be join file, because it will be a join of this file and this file. So we are merging two files. Shall I click on OK? Yes, my friends. Because once I click on OK, you can't see this once again. So if you have any problem, I will wait here. So out of 54 participants, only 2-3 people have replied. Yes. If the customer account number which is here, which is not here, it will not come, because I am saying what? All records in the primary file. Okay, so out of this 1000 customers, suppose there are 50 customers which are not here, they will not get picked up. And if there are the 10 accounts here for which there is no customer detail, they will be left blank. Okay, now I am clicking on OK. So see, this is a combined file. Up to here, this is my primary file. See this five columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here they are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now if I open the customer details, there are again five columns in the customer detail, which are from here. Hope you understand what we did. So what join did? Join command looked at this account number, which is account number 2004190, in which file? Customer detail file. Okay, and in the customer detail file, the same account number is appearing, and it has given us the name of the customer, address of the customer, city and state. Account number is repeated because it is joined, isn't it? Hope I am making sense. This account number is in the secondary file and this account number is in the primary file. Now, if you don't want this, you can delete this column. I have not shown you how to delete, but I will show you how to delete. Alternatively, what Gitesh is saying is also right. If you don't need this column because it is already there here, then at the time of joining, you can select which columns you don't want. Let me show you what Jitesh is meaning. So when I'm saying join, there's an option called fields. Okay. When I click on fields, by default, all the columns of the second file are selected. Now I already know that account number is there in my primary file. I don't need this here. So just click on it. When you deselect it and you say OK and you say OK, see what happened. Now there is no account number column in this join. See, it starts with the customer name and only account number is here. So if you see this join file, this has an account number. When I did it again, now there is nothing. So the flexibility is there. The more you work on the tool, the better you become. Considering the time, I am showing you plain vanilla things. Okay. Yes, of course I will repeat. Let me read Priyanka's message. No customer details will appear against the account number which were not present in the customer detail file. No, it is other way around, Priyanka. What option we selected? We selected the option all records in the primary file. So what does it mean? Just have a look. It extracts all records from the primary file with or without matches in the secondary file. So please understand, Priyanka, that if in my primary file, which is this, if this account number 63604592, there is no customer detail, in the joint database it will show blank. But if in my customer details, if this account number is there, 2018299, but if it is not there here, it will not come. Hope you have understood, Priyanka. Now, Ramana wants to repeat the last step. Okay, I'll repeat it from the beginning. Yeah, so your understanding is right, Priyanka. I may have read your chat incorrectly then, but you have understood it right. Okay, great. Now, Mr. Ramana, I am doing it once again. Just have a look. I am closing everything. Just from the start, I am doing. I am opening the savings account balance file. This is my primary file. Okay. I am clicking on join. I am selecting the second file, which is customer details. I am going to fields. And I'm deselecting this because it is the repeat column. Yeah, this is what I'm doing. Ramana, you have to click here and deselect it. You can clear all, you can include all, you can select the columns which you don't want. Anything which is in white will not come. Anything in blue will come. Suppose city and state. You know that everything is in US, but you are interested only in city. You are not interested in state. So that's fine. Yeah. So I am selecting three columns. Okay. And I'm saying okay. Now I click on match. Account number. Okay. And okay. So see. Now my account number column is missing. My state column is also missing. So hope you guys are having good time understanding this tool. Are you finding it convenient to use? Any feedbacks, any comments, any observations? Do you feel very heavy using this tool since last couple of hours? Great. Okay. Thank you, Govind. Great. Thank you, Geeta. We will discuss everything about cost, where to download, how to procure on the last day. First, let us spend time on learning. All of this on the last day. Of course, Geetesh, we will do complex case study. Not on the last day, on the third day itself. Yeah, we will not leave complex things on the last day. Otherwise, you will not understand. We'll keep it on the third day itself. First 2 days, we have spent time to make you comfortable. Next 3 days, it's all case studies. Okay? Now, if you are willing to do some activity during these 3 days, because we are now going to meet on Monday, I guess. Are you willing to do something? Shall I give you some work to do at home? Yeah, all right. Now, please note down. Let me share my screen. Okay. I want you guys to import two files. One is a vehicle claim file and vehicle policy master file. Priyanka is saying, my question to all application related to bank audit data only? No. If you see, look at the files, they are mixed files. And the case studies are from different industries. Like I have a case study on an insurance company. That is what you are going to see. I have case studies on various frauds. Yeah, so it is not related to bank only. Okay. It can be used by anybody, Chirag. Okay, it can be used by anybody. It all depends upon what is your end objective. See, if you are into taxation practice, if you are into GST or income tax or finance, probably it will be of very limited use. Any practice that requires analysis of data, like if you are into due diligence, then due diligence requires analyzing past so many years of data, see how the projections are made, how the valuations are arrived. For that, suppose a company whose valuation is been done and you are appointed to recheck the valuation, and their majority of the assets are in investments into securities. Now, to value investment in securities, you might be looking at last past 7-8 years of NAVs, 7-8 years of closing prices every day. Then this tool is useful. So whenever large volume of data, this tool will be handy. Otherwise, there is no use. For accounting, you cannot use. For reconciliation, very limited use. For finalization of books, no use. For adjustment entries, no use. Only for analysis. Okay. Now, the activity that you should do is, can you see these two files? Yes. Internal audit, it is one of the best tool. And on the last day, I will show you one case study how using this tool we have automated various checks and balances of the client. Okay. See, I told you yesterday in the beginning, L&T, entire internal audit division, is on the idea. Imagine such a large company, minimum 150 people is the strength of L&T audit team, entirely doing routine checks on idea kind of a software. So much value can come from that field. Okay. Two-way RICO, I think God cannot do this now. Only GST authorities can do. They are also unaware how to do that. Yeah. God is the only father for two-way reconciliation. Okay. Thankfully, I am not in that domain. So I have very limited idea on GST reconciliations. All right. Now, please import this vehicle claims and vehicle policy master. Okay. And find out, are there any duplicate policies? Okay. That is one activity that you have to do based on whatever I have taught you. That is first activity. Second activity, you have to import this sales register file and find out, are there any duplicate invoices? Okay. And run duplicate on one column, two column, three column, four column, four fields. You can pick choose based on your knowledge and generate four different duplicate checks. Are we all clear with the homework? Can we do this much for me? Very simple things, nothing complicated. Okay. So sales register, vehicle policy master, and vehicle claims. Import this, find duplicates for me. And same thing you can do. No, but I have not taught you. So this much you can do. Same, find out duplicate in sales register using one column duplication like invoice number, two columns like invoice number and date, three columns like invoice number, date, region, four columns like invoice number, date, region, product name. See yourself what is the kind of output you are getting. Okay. So this much is your homework for today. You can do it over 3 days and we will again connect back on Monday at 6 p.m. And my number is there. If anyone has a problem installing IDEA, you can connect back. So with this, over to you, Yogesh. Thank you very much. You guys have a wonderful evening ahead and a nice weekend too. See you on Monday.
Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you very much. Just to give you a quick update of what I covered today, a few things that were file import and export and some hygiene check that you've done, obtaining and importing files of different format, file management problem during the file import. So these are the few things. Along with this, there was you have combined two files together and done certain analysis there. So like one small thing that I would like to mention, there's a separate urge that you have created among all the members of learning and studying. So that's a very beautiful thing that I can see in the group as well. In fact, yesterday one member called me and he told me that, no, he has deregistered for the seminar, but he has registered it again only because he liked the way you are actually taking forward the whole session. Basically, he mentioned that your style is very good for learning it. So yeah, that's it from our side, and we will come back Monday again for the session, and hope we will enjoy in the similar manner that we have enjoyed in the last 2 days. Thanks a lot, sir.
That's very encouraging, Yogesh, to know the feedback from the participants. And as I said, my endeavor is that at the end of the fifth day, you should all be inclined to learn, practice on this tool, and you know, make your life convenient. So we'll ensure that you achieve that objective from the training that you're enrolled for. All right. Cheers then. Good night. Bye, Yogesh.